In high school.
And how old are you?
I am 50.
Okay, so you're in good shape.
Here's my invoice for my camera.
Yep.
I mailed it the 21st to Casio, and today is the 10th. So a few days to get there, and a few days to get back, and they shipped it back for me, and I'm using it right now. Casio. Where's my old camera?
Leave that money where it is.
You know, you get used to these things, no matter how crazy the menus are, you get used to them. So this one's got an extra long zoom and an extra wide, wide-angle fisheye lens, but it's also a giant size. I'm going to keep it. The lens a couple times here and there didn't retract properly, and ooh, got some nice heat. Yeah, burn that oil. Beautiful. Chevrolet! I got a few things I got to show you. This is my two-wheel drive pickup that I bought back, 8 years ago. And when I was pushing it in the garage, I forgot about these bloody towing mirrors. And crunch! Luckily, I got lots of parts trucks. Just a tiny bit of damage to the door. That's what concerned me more, because that just popped right out. Windows are replaceable. Rust-free doors, a lot less so. Just a little dent. This truck used to be brown, the same color as my buddy Eric's. He had a two-wheel drive just like this with a 305, 77, this is a 79. Oh, I got a lot of work to do here to put this thing back together. This is the motor from my Caprice, some 350 lump a guy traded me for my Buick that I had before this. I had a 78 Buick Century Wagon, mid-size rear-wheel drive. Kind of sort of the Malibu Le Mans style. Ran well, used it for years. Spike Punk rebuilt the Turbo 350 that was in it with a 3.8 V6. It was a good car. Drove it for years and years till the floors rusted out. And some guy said, I'll buy it. I said, car's junk. Tranny's slipping after 90,000 miles. And the motor had almost 200,000. Was burning lots of oil. It's getting kind of noisy. So he traded me for this 350 that he claimed only had 50,000 miles, but I think they all have 50,000 miles. Anyhow, it runs. I'm going to put it back together or hire someone to do it and then sell it. It's from California. Been off the road for 7 or 8 years now. It's just got a little bit of rust in the floor reinforcement, but the rest of it's all nice and shiny clean. Smashed window. Couple of 350s in the back. Bolts on the floor. Oh boy. It had a turbo 400, but the guy who was switching the motor for me that never got around to switching it took the tranny. We'll never know where it went. I didn't take it. The other guy took it. Yeah, right. Spare parts. So what I'm doing right now, after opening up the box with my camera so I can take this one out of my pouch. What I'm doing now, I worked on the Hyundai a little bit. What I'm doing now is I'm enlarging the bolts that hold the scraper edge to this Fisher plow that I bought for $50. The carriage bolts that were original equipment were all loose. Two of them were busted and they were wobbling in the holes. So my buddy Sharpshooter in Boston said, no, they're no good. I said, well, what am I supposed to do? I got a plow. I'm not going to weld the scraper edge on like it was in my POS plow truck. So I was thinking about it. I said, well, wait a minute. The holes are already ovaled. I'll just enlarge them with the torch right there on the ground. And I'll put in some 5/8 bolts. This is a junk one, a Kmart bolt. But I do have some grade 8s right here. And they cost 5/8 by 2-inch. I don't know how many centimeters that is. Cost. I always mark the price on the package. This is from a wholesaler.
Oh,
man.
Go toward that goal of paying off the house early and saving what you said, should I?
5/8 by 2-inch. 5 screws for $7.50. That means $1.50 a screw. That's wholesale price, supposedly. $1.50 a screw for grade 8. So I've been torching the holes, just two sides, doing a hack job. And I know it's supposed to be carriage bolts, but I'm not really too concerned about it. Look at the blade. It really needs to be straightened. I could take the whole thing apart, sandblast it. And I can't get the pivot pin in here because it's been gone for so long that the plow has bent out of shape. And I tried wailing on it with the hammer, but all I did was ring it, ringing in my ears. So, see those pins wear out. It's a high mileage plow, as they all are when I buy them for junk. And what I could do is I could cut this strut. I could cut it and weld it on lower down so the holes line up, or I could cut the tabs off the pivot and weld those higher up. Sounds like I'd be taking apart the whole plow. Bent. Junk. I was watching Corruptor's videos and he showed me a two-wheel drive C10. What a POS. Guy bought it for scrap for $50 and he puts it on his lot for $750. What a total piece of crap. Had a late model aluminum wheels that were worth $20 each for scrap. Look at that, rusted right through. Oh boy. Just doesn't pay to put any time into this plow. Just doesn't pay. I should just weld it up the way it is. Hammer it back into shape. Weld it back together. I just like to do something with this here. I'm not going to waste $100 of gas. What could I do to pull that back? I'll think about it. One of my pistons, the end broke off, so I just welded that back on. Works. Saw a guy at the plow shop. He had a mint hydraulic arm ram, and the end was rotted off. And I wanted him to give it to me, but he just took off. So, I'm going to continue on my task. I've got the tripod on the camera, so I'll put it here. I'll zoom in, I'll bend it over a little bit, and you can watch. It's just about to tip over, isn't it? There. All right.
Tighten up my
lard.
It's chili.
Chili, we aren't even in South America. Put my gloves on. They're in my pocket. These gloves used to be two gloves for a dollar. And they were two gloves for a dollar and a quarter. They were two gloves for $1.50. Now they're two gloves for $2.
He joins us now.
25 cent increments.
Tom, welcome to the show.
They work.
Thank you very much for having me.
Keep my hands a lot warmer.
I've been reading your call up for loading for years now.
Goggles, made in USA.
That you were leaving this year. You know, considering
made in USA
antique
pure torch.
Why would someone leave such a stable job?
Made in USA Sparker. Crier up!
I turned 55 and
the torch. Toasty warm.
Was
heat it up first. It's a thick piece of steel. And you add oxygen, lots of oxygen. All the stuff you got red hot just blows away. I made that hole a little too big. Too big, but square. A little bit more trimming. There we go. Slide my blade back up into position. Make sure that I'm in the holes. Line up! I think that's a mistake. Don't line up. SOL. I think there's always opportunities and equities. So I know it's been a bolt on this side.
He hasn't gone anywhere since the late 90s, and that's true.
That's
possible it'll be another loss decade.
But done.
I think
for Van Gogh, once
you're just so afraid of risk,
tight.
I think ultimately it comes to the
I'm sure no 2 days worth the same for you, covering the
what's going to happen, huh?
For most people,
you still watching?
Like human nature.
Of course you are. You're real obedient. I tell you, sit behind that computer and watch this video. There. Oh, I've got a nut. There's a gust of it. I feel it. Love it.
There, see?
Nuts.
Hey! You have to try
to
fight and bite your instincts specifically at exactly the point that you should be biting on.
Right.
The other thing is, you can
last hole, last call for alcohol.
Right? I mean, people spend more time going over a restaurant menu than they will in 1 year looking at their 401k on.
Fire up!
Something I try to remind my readers of.
Last call for alcohol. Last hole, loudly. I'll sing to you. Almost done. All done. I'm going to share some thoughts with you.
It's going well.
I'm getting tired of driving that Hyundai. It rhymes with Sunday around. So I'm thinking of selling the Hyundai. Oop, unzoom. I'm thinking of selling the Hyundai and getting a Volkswagen Golf hatchback. I don't want a Jetta. I want a hatchback. A lot easier to do trash with. I prefer the big wide opening. So I was looking on Craigslist. I saw a few. I want a 99 or up, I think. Or maybe I don't. So that hole is not going to line up. I'm going to have to retorch. Nope, look at that. So folks on YouTube that are knowledgeable in things that I may not be knowledgeable. Boy, I made that hole real big, didn't I? Maybe I should go one size bigger to 3/4. Folks that are knowledgeable, let me know about buying a Golf. I saw one. The guy said the transmission has had no reverse for the last 3 years. I just parked very carefully. It was an automatic transmission, but I don't want an automatic. That's freaking rinky-dink. I want a stick shift. I'd like to have a 5-speed Suburban. I wonder if they made the Suburbans with the 5-speed. They used to make the Suburbans with the 4-speed. I've seen a few of those. Very, very few. That's the SM465. But let me know what you think. I'm going to have to weld that together. Let me know what you think about a Volkswagen Golf. I'm going to have to buy one probably in Florida because Mrs. CW and I are going there in a couple of months. I don't know when exactly, but we'll hire a guy that I sold a plow truck to, an 83 three-quarter ton four-speed manual 350 rusted. I bought it for $150. And I sold it for a lot more than that. Just needed a few things. Tires were all leaking, all four tires. And what else was wrong with it? Frost plug had rusted out. I put a frost plug in it, fixed the tires, did a few small repairs to it. Exhaust manifold had fallen off. The studs were rusted. I fixed one side. Didn't get around to the other side. And sold it. It was snowing, so sold real fast. Anyhow, let me know what you think of the Volkswagen Golf. I think I want to buy a diesel Golf 5-speed, 2 or 4-door, doesn't matter. Maybe even a 4-door is preferable. Maybe I should throw this emergency brake cable away. I was thinking about keeping it. Like everything else I keep, I need that tighter spring if it doesn't work well with the cable that I bought. It's got that light-duty spring. How do you get that end off and then put it back on, factory style? Don't know. Maybe I'll use a cable end. Well, I gotta fix this chain. I don't like the look of this chain. It's freaking rinky-dink. Broken links. It's pretty high up, huh? Alrighty. Put my bolts back in. Some welding plates on that. Crack. And this is a 16-minute video. Ding! 17 minutes. And then I'm gonna eat some carrots. So what is it, 3 hours later? It's almost 6 o'clock, time for Garrison Keillor. While you've been sleeping, I've been welding on some pieces of steel, welding up the cracks, hammering, heating, banging, clanging, grinding, ground a line so that my 4-inch wide piece of 1/8, like that crack, yeah. I'm going to weld a big piece right across the front, 2 pieces, a long piece and a short piece, just like that. I'm going to quit early tonight. I wanted to get this blazer out of the way and take the red truck out and put the San Francisco sub inside and start doing the driver's side ball joint. Because we're going to New York City, I think, on Thursday. I'm going to take this Suburban. I better get that thing put back together, huh? Just need the steering box change. That will be here on Thursday. I bought parts from Advance Auto. They have a great deal, $50 off and 15% off or $50 gift card. Anyways, I called him up. I said, Rock Auto's got better prices. He says, no problemo. We'll match them. So there's no shipping, I don't think. Forgot to ask. Could have picked it up in the store if they would have had it in the store, but they had nothing in the store. But you got to pay sales tax. Rock Auto hasn't got a presence in this state, but Advance Auto does, so you save the shipping. Rock Auto was shipping from all different places. Every part came from a different place. You had $8, $16, $12. So I got steering box coming, ball joints, Pitman arm. Gotta weld this up right now. Weld away. Fix this junk Fisher plow. As in a myth or fairy tale. So it's after 7 o'clock, Garrison Keillor's half over. I hope to be there. Is it next week or the week after? I realize. And I welded right across the top. Oh, boy. Where my mother and my two sisters and I so slow. Regrouped and regathered. And across the bottom, I stitched it. Weld a couple inches, leave a few inches. The dinner time table. So that's it. I think I'm done for the night. I'm going to go over to the log house, though, and change the circulating pump because we got somebody moving in there Monday. I think I need a new toque. This one's falling apart. Where would I find it? It was made in Brooklyn. They used to sell them at Walmart. Triple layer. Top of the line. All right, I'm freezing. I've had enough of this. Got to work on that thing, too, and I got to work on the red two-wheel drive. I got too many T-Rucks. Too many T-Rucks.